Hey guys, welcome to Food and Frolic. I'm Akshada Desai Lobo and today I'll be showing you the recipe for very simple Maharashtrian style curry called Takachi Kadhi. Takachi Kadhi is basically a kadhi or a curry made with yogurt and it really goes well with rice. And I like to serve it with a side of besan sa pora, which is sort of like your pakoda but it's not deep fried. The combination is just amazing. You definitely do need to try it out. So let's get started. To make this, I first started with around 4 cloves of garlic. As you can see, the garlic cloves are really huge, so in case you're using the thin ones, make sure to use an equivalent amount. Now roughly crush these cloves of garlic. You don't need to mash them into a paste, you just need them to release all their juices. And then take a big large bowl to mix 1 cup of yogurt, it's plain unsalted yogurt, which you need to mix with around 1/4 cup of besan or gram flour. Then I like to use my tiny whisk to whisk it all together into a smooth paste. Now, the quantity of besan actually depends on how thick or runny you like the curry. I prefer it to be on a thicker side, which is why I like to use a 1/4 cup. In case you like it a little runny, you can even use 2 tablespoons or so. Now, once all the besan is well combined with the yogurt, you need to add water. The reason we add water after whisking it is so that it doesn't form any lumps. Whisk it all together really well. Now what you can see is sort of the consistency that you should be looking for. It's sort of like a very thin batter. Now set this aside and to finally give it tadka, I had heated an earthen pot already. You know, so that it doesn't break because of any shock. Let me know if you have any questions around it and I'll try my best to answer them in the comments below. Once the oil is hot, give it tadka with some rai, jeera, a pinch of hing, 1 green chili which is finely chopped, 1 dried red chili and a few curry leaves. Add your crushed garlic and stir it all together so that the oil is infused with all the flavors. And once all of these have changed their color ever so slightly, you can add in your besan and dahi mixture. Now keep stirring it on a very low flame so that it doesn't form any lumps and also so that it doesn't stick to the bottom of the pan. And as I said, we keep the curry very simple with very basic flavors. So I like to use some salt, turmeric and a bit of sugar. Actually a good teaspoon or a tablespoon of sugar. But if you don't prefer it sweet, I would still recommend you to add like a tiny pinch just to balance out the sourness of yogurt. Now mix it all well together and let it come to a boil. You'll also notice that the curry turns bright yellow as it boils. At this point, you should leave it undisturbed for say 5 to 7 minutes on a very low flame so that it doesn't spill over. So when I shared this recipe on Instagram, I received a lot of comments saying that how can you boil the curry for like so less time, you know? Because I know there are different ways of making curry in India and many different cultures boil it for much longer, say half an hour or so. But how we make it is by letting it come to just one boil, ukri as we call it. That means the curry just rises to the top of the pot once and that's it, we turn off the flame. And right before taking it off the flame, we add some coriander leaves. And that's literally it. Our delicious curry is ready to be served. Look at that amazing consistency. Not too thick, not too runny. It's just perfect for me. In case you want it thicker, you can always keep it longer for boiling. It best goes with steaming hot rice. In case you like this video, do check out my other videos and subscribe to my channel. And thank you for watching. Bye!